So what we are going to see, how to create a service and what exactly intent redelivery is, right? See, what I did, I have already created a service, my service, which is extending the service class. And just for explanation, I have taken what? Media player. Make sure that when you create a service from the Android Studio facility, service has been registered in the manifest file or not. That has been registered. Okay. So I created this service. Then what happens is that when you extend, when you create a service, service is having only one abstract method, which is nothing but what? On unbind. Presently, I'm not using it, right? I'm not using this. Can be used at the time of bound services, inter process communication, right? Or intra process communication can be achieved by means of this way. So service can be started in a two ways. One way is nothing but by means of start service, and another way is nothing but what? Bind service. Start service and the bind service are two ways. Okay, so let's focus on the service. So I have override on start command method. On start command, what you can say, is one of the lifecycle method. On start command, if you see, on start command is one of the lifecycle method. On bind is also lifecycle method. On create and on destroy, these are the four lifecycle methods, right? Now, when you talk about the service, right? When you talk about the service, you are actually talking about a sibling of the activity. You're actually talking about what? Sibling of the activity. Now, what do you mean by sibling? Both are indirectly extending to the context class. Both are the context. One is having some visual interface. One is running in the background thing. For example, WhatsApp. You start uploading image to the WhatsApp, right? And suddenly you switch to the Gmail, but still WhatsApp image upload is working. Because of whom? Because of the service. So service is a foreground component. For more theory, you can read this. Three types of services: foreground, background and the bound. So we are working with these services now, right? One more thing, these services are having some limitation. We'll see that little bit later on, what limitation is there. Now if you see, yes, background execution limit, we'll see what exactly it is. Now if you can see, inside this service I have taken let init var media player. So what is going to happen when this service is going to be started? Whenever this service is going to be started, media player object is going to be created, right? And you are going to listen one of the music. Now for that I have created simple user interface like this. If you can see, service, I have created a simple user interface, start and the stop. Right, if I start it, you will find when music is getting played. I can stop it, service is getting stopped. If you want to see the code, you can see button start would be starting the service, start service, right? And BT button stop is going to what? Stop the service. So services can be stopped by their own, by the call, something called as stop self. Or servicing can be stopped by another components like activities. That can be done. So what I'm trying to do, in the raw I have a.mp3 and the b.mp3. I have created one raw resource, and in that raw resource I have taken a.mp3 and the b.mp3, right? Whenever I'm creating the intent, can you see this? Likewise, you started the activity and passed the this object, right, as a context, and next activity reference as your type information. Same thing is true about the service. So you are passing this and you are passing what? My service. So this is a type information of service class. Okay, then we are putting one key underscore mp3, and we are passing a over here, r.raw.a.mp3. We are passing integer reference. Remember that int dot put extra, this is nothing but what? Integer. And then you are starting service, you are stopping service. The moment start service is going to be fired, this method is going to be called, immediately on start command. On create would be getting called, on start would be getting called, and remember that this intent is that intent. Because of this intent, right? Because of this intent, this service has been started, and this intent contains one of the key. So what we did, if that intent is null, right? If this intent is null, this can be null, right? Play the b.mp3. Else you can play whatever you can say that intent is giving you. Intent.getIntExtraKey.mp3, default value would be B once again, right? And you have called what? This mp3.start. Now here if you can see, so this flag is all about intent redelivery. Now go to this flag. There are two things: start sticky and start not sticky. Let's get the proof. What do you mean by start sticky? First, I am going to have start sticky, which is same as start sticky compatibility. So compatibility covers all the compatibility related concerns. So but start sticky and start sticky compatibility are same. I'll select start sticky compatibility and let me play it once again and see what happens. So intent redelivery, remember that. Now I am starting, right? And see, it's working in the background fine. It's typically working in the background, but let me try to kill the process. Now I'm killing the process. Now you will find, instead of A, B would be playing, right? You can see Chip Thrills is running now. Now let me stop it, service, and stop it. When you click on the stop, MP3 media player is going to be stopped, the hardware resources are going to be released, and then your service is going to be what? Destroyed. Okay, but what happened exactly here? What do you mean by start sticky and what do you mean by start not sticky? See, let's get the output of start not sticky then, and let's run the code. Now see, you'll find some another result. Start, let me kill the process. Nothing is happening. But in the case of start sticky compatibility, some another things are happening. See, start, let me kill the process, and you will find something else, right? Service. Now what exactly happening? What do you mean by start sticky and start not sticky? Let's go here and check. So here they are saying start sticky, say start sticky compatibility same as what? Start sticky. The start sticky is here. You can say constant to return from on start command. If service process is killed while it is started, right? Then leave it in the started state, but don't retain the delivered intent. Means which intent? This intent. It will not remember the data of this intent. And that's why you might have observed at the first time it plays b.mp3, and at the second time it plays what? a.mp3. Sorry, at the first time it plays a.mp3, and at the second time it plays what? b.mp3, because this intent is what? Null. And what it does, and later the system will try to recreate the service, and again this service code is going to be get executed, but intent's data is going to be forgotten. Means when you make a start sticky, your intent, delivered intent would be null, right? Your delivered intent data would be forgotten, right? But it will try to recreate the service, and that's why it starts playing the cheap thrills. But in the case of start not sticky, it forgets the intent and it And what you can say, it does not try to recreate the service. That's what they have written in the start, not sticky. Right? So it will forget the service. It will forget, what you can say, redelivered intent. That things would be happening by means of start sticky and start not sticky. Remember that service and intent redelivery, this is all about. Okay, fine.